I'm Mark Brown. We're here in the TAO Las Vegas kitchen, preparing what we're making for the Las Vegas Food and Wine Festival. So basically right here what we're making is our pan seared barbecue pork buns. We'll start off with fresh ground compart duroc pork, which is all natural. Some thin sliced shiitake mushroom. We've got some Napa cabbage, chopped scallions, a little Chinese chili paste, Chinese cooking wine, a little bit of sweet soy, and fresh chopped ginger. So all these are going to be going into our blender right now. We'll start off, get the pan nice and hot. Oil. You just want to get this nice and hot so you throw the mushrooms in. They don't sog out, they get nice and crispy right off the
I like a lot because it's nice and thick, but doesn't have that super salty taste that a lot of the thick and dark soy.
this out in a sheet tray. Get it cooled down. And it'll be ready to steam and put into our fresh made bao dough. Alright, so now we got our filling kind of chilled down. Scoop into little individual portions here. And here we have is our fresh bao dough that we make every morning in-house. These gotta be made daily. Kind of full of daily, cook daily, and they come out really nice and light. So basically all this is you got a Hong Kong rose flour, which is similar to a kind of a bread flour here. Mix a little bit of yeast, you got a little bit of tapioca starch, some salt, sugar. Go ahead and make a traditional, traditional bread dough, let it rise, roll it out like this, and then kind of flatten it out a bit. You don't want to incorporate any more flour to it, you don't want to overwork it, because the point of a bao dough, people like the nice, light, airy, that's kind of the best part, so you try to be really gentle with it. Got your fingers flatten it out. That. Take your filling, right there in the middle. Just slowly, you crimp up the edges. Like this. Get a little twist on it. Right to our steamer basket with them. The key too when you're working with dough is that it's got to be at room temperature. If it's got any chill in it at all, it's going to force you to have to work too hard with it, and the more you have to work with it, the tougher the dough is going to get, and you'll lose that really tender feel to it. You gotta space them out because they'll almost double in size when they go under the steamer. These baskets make a really great dessert though too. Stuff them like a chilled cheesecake with some chocolate, throw them in the fryer. Have a good snack here in the kitchen. Run them as a special once in a while, they're always a big hit. You know, on the weekends, we'll definitely still, on busy nights, we could do anywhere from, 1,000 to 1,200, 1,300 on a super busy week. And then, get banquets going, get the beach going at the same time. Alright, so this is ready to go in our steamer. Pop this off steaming for about 8 to 9 minutes. After our bao's come out of the steamer, as you can see, they're nice and puffy, nice, light, and airy. Kind of the fun twist that we put on them is we then pan sear them. So they get a nice crispy crust on them, so you end up getting a nice crispy crunch. We also saw that nice tender dough in the middle. Alright, make sure your pan's nice and hot. Go ahead, start to pan sear these off. Moving a little bit in the very beginning, because this dough being as tender as it is, gets a little sticky. You don't want to stick to the pan. hot chili. A little goes a long way. This has that nice roasted chili flavor to it. I get that all around. Buns ready for Las Vegas food and wine.